Hi, I'm MaZee from MaZee, and in this video, I'll be showing you how you can install Bluestacks on your M1 Mac. We'll be using a recent version of Bluestacks which works on M1 Mac. It's called Bluestacks X, and by the end of this video, you will go from having this error on your screen to having Bluestacks running on your Mac. So let's get started. Before we continue, let's give a super quick shout out to our sponsor for this video, Template Monster. They have an amazing product called Monster One, and if you are a developer, you'll be able to get premium digital assets like WordPress themes, stock videos, and graphics at a very competitive price. I've dropped the link in the description. At the time of this recording, if you go to bluestacks.com and click on See All Versions, you'll notice that Bluestacks 5 is not yet available for Mac OS, and you can only download version 4. The problem, however, is that if you click on the download button, you will get an Intel-based version which will give you this error when you try to install it. Unfortunately, Bluestacks has no M1 support for version 4. However, there is a newer version called Bluestacks X. I have dropped the link to the download page in the description as well. But the problem is, when you click on the download button, you will most likely still see the version 4 being downloaded. And this is because Bluestacks X is not currently available globally, so you will need to turn on your VPN to download it if you are not in one of the supported countries. Opera browser comes with a free VPN, so let's use it for this video. If you do not have Opera, head over to opera.com and click on download. Once you have it downloaded and installed, open it and then click on File, then select New Private Window. You will see the VPN tag up here, click on it, select America and then turn it on. Now navigate to Bluestacks X page again and click on download. This time it will start downloading the correct version for you. And once it's done downloading, you can install it like so. I hope you found this video helpful. Let me know if you have any questions in the comment section. Don't forget to give this video a like, and I'll see you in the next one.